Welcome viewers, we are today going to discuss organometallic compounds. This is the third episode on organometallic compounds. In the earlier two episodes, we have discussed the structure, formation and reactions undergone by organomagnesium compounds, which are also called Grignard reagent. In the present episode, we are going to discuss the importance of organozinc compounds. We will discuss the nomenclature of organometallic compounds in general. Then we will also discuss carbon metal bond in organometallic compounds, the polarity of this carbon metal bond in organometallic compound. Then we will discuss organozinc compounds in particular, where we will discuss their preparation. We will discuss the reaction undergone by organozinc compound, a very popularly known reaction, Simon-Smith reaction. We will discuss the mechanism of Simon-Smith reaction and stereospecificity associated with this reaction. We will then discuss retrosynthetic analysis and then similarity between Simon-Smith reaction with that of epoxidation. We will discuss nucleophilic addition to carbonyl compounds, and then we will discuss some application of organozinc compounds in synthetic organic chemistry. Organozinc compounds are utilized for Reformatsky reaction. They are utilized for Negishi coupling, then for Barbier reaction and for Franklin-Dupper reaction. These organozinc compounds are used. So, to start with, the importance of organozinc reagents. The organozinc reagents are an indispensable part of synthetic chemist knowledge. Nowadays, almost every synthesis of natural product has at least one step which involves the use of this kind of compounds. Therefore, there is a constant need for the development of new methods for the straightforward and efficient preparation of zinc organometallics. We will discuss the nomenclature of organometallic compounds in general. Organometallic compounds are named as substituted derivatives of metals. The metal is the parent and the alkyl group is identified by the appropriate prefix. For example, cyclopropyl group attached to lithium metal, hence the molecule is named as cyclopropyl lithium. For example, when cyclopropyl group is attached to lithium metal, the name of the molecule becomes cyclopropyl lithium. As in this example, you can see this is the cyclopropyl group and this is attached to lithium metal. Hence, the name of the molecule is cyclopropyl lithium. When the metal bears a substituent other than carbon, the substituent is treated as anion and is named separately. For example, magnesium is bonded to carbon of methyl group and to iodine also, as in this case you can see here. This magnesium is attached to iodine as well as to the carbon of methyl. Hence, the name of the molecule is methyl magnesium iodide. Another example where zinc is bonded to carbon of iodomethyl group and to iodine also. That is why the name of the molecule becomes iodomethyl zinc iodide. You can see here this zinc metal is attached to iodine and this is also attached to carbon of iodomethyl group. Hence, the name of the molecule is iodomethyl zinc iodide. Another example where the metal zinc provides the base or parent name. As you can see, the alkyl group which is bonded to zinc, this is the alkyl group, this is tertiary butyl group which is bonded to zinc, and that is why the name of the molecule is tertiary butyl zinc. The name of the molecule can also be 1,1-dimethyl ethyl zinc also. Can you tell why is it so? Why the molecule can be named as tertiary butyl zinc also as well as 1,1-dimethyl ethyl zinc? The reason is that this is the carbon chain, the ethyl carbon chain. The first carbon of this ethyl carbon chain is substituted with 2 methyl groups. Hence, the name of this alkyl side chain can also be 1,1-dimethyl ethyl. Hence, the name 1,1-dimethyl ethyl zinc may be given to this molecule. Now, we will discuss the carbon metal bond in organometallic compounds. The electronegativity of carbon is 2.5. Hence, it is neither strongly electropositive nor strongly electronegative or nucleophilic in nature. When it is bonded to atoms having higher electronegativity than 2.5, that is oxygen or chlorine, the bond is polarized and carbon becomes slightly positive. When it is bonded to atoms having lower electronegativity than 2.5, that is metals like sodium, lithium, magnesium, zinc, etc., the bond is polarized and the carbon becomes slightly electronegative. Look at the electronegativities of the metals like lithium, sodium, potassium and magnesium compared to that of carbon and other atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and chlorine. In case of carbon lithium, carbon zinc and carbon magnesium bond, the carbon atom is more electronegative as compared to the other atom attached to it. But when you look at carbon oxygen, carbon nitrogen or carbon chlorine bond, you will find here that since the carbon here is attached to more electronegative element, it is electropositive in nature. You can see this with the help of the partial periodic table with Pauling electronegativity. Here you can see that all these metals, they have electronegativity less than that of carbon, that is 2.5, and the elements here in this part of periodic table have electronegativity more than carbon. Here it is carbon. So, any element attached to carbon, if it has electronegativity more than 2.5, carbon will acquire slightly positive charge in that bond, or the polarity of the bond becomes polar and carbon gets slightly positive charge. Whereas, when carbon is attached to any of these metals like lithium, sodium, potassium or magnesium, then compared to carbon, their electronegativity is less or they are more electropositive than carbon. As a result, carbon here gets a negative charge. Here, with the help of the example of methyl fluoride and methyl lithium, you can see the electrostatic potential mapping of methyl fluoride and methyl lithium. The electronic distribution is reversed in these two compounds. You can see that carbon is electron deficient, colored as blue in case of methyl fluoride, whereas carbon is electron rich in case of methyl lithium and is colored red. I think you know the reason behind it very clearly, because in this case, if you compare the electronegativity of carbon with that of fluorine, you know very well that fluorine is much more electronegative compared to carbon. That is why carbon is polarized as an electron deficient part of the molecule. Whereas, here in this case, carbon has higher electronegativity compared to lithium, hence it gets slightly negative charge compared to that of lithium. When carbon is bonded to a more electronegative element such as halogen, the electron in the bond are more strongly attracted towards the more electronegative element halogen. But in case carbon is bonded to less electronegative element such as metal, the electron in the bond are more strongly attracted towards more electronegative element carbon. This can be shown with the help of these two figures. Here the carbon is attached to a halogen which is more electronegative, hence carbon acquires slightly positive charge and halogen acquires slightly negative charge. In the other case, carbon is attached to a metal which is less electronegative, or you can say it is more electropositive compared to carbon. As a result, the bonded electron pair between carbon and metal is shifted more towards carbon, making carbon electronegative than the metal. The alkyl groups attached to metals in organometallic compound have carbanionic character because metals are electropositive than carbon. Carbon acquires negative charge and is referred to as carbanion. We will now see the polarity of carbon metal bond in an organic compound. In this table, here the percentage ionic character associated with different carbon metal bond have been shown. If you look at the percentage ionic character between carbon and lithium, you will find that it is 60% ionic bond. Between carbon and magnesium, the bond is 52% ionic in nature, whereas in case of carbon and zinc bond, it is only 36% ionic in nature. How do we calculate the percentage ionic character? With the help of electronegativity associated with carbon minus that of the metal divided by the electronegativity of carbon multiplied by 100, and you will find these values. It is very obvious from this table that carbon lithium bond will have more ionic character, because there is remarkable difference in the electronegativity of carbon and lithium. As the difference between the two, that is carbon and metal, decreases, the ionic character also decreases. Organometallic compounds have carbon ionic character. The ionic character increases with the increase in electropositivity of the metal. That is why organosodium and organopotassium compounds have ionic character, or they have ionic carbon metal bond. Organolithium, organomagnesium and organozinc compounds have polar and covalent carbon metal bond. It is the carbon ionic character of these compounds which is responsible for their usefulness as synthetic reagents. We will now discuss organozinc compounds. Organozinc compounds are the compounds which contain carbon zinc chemical bond. Organozinc compounds were among the first organometallic compounds prepared. They are less reactive than organolithium compound and organomagnesium compounds. In the year 1848, Edward Franklin prepared the first organozinc compound, diethyl zinc, by heating ethyl iodide in presence of zinc metal. This reaction produced a volatile colorless liquid that undergo combustion spontaneously upon contact with air. Due to their pyrophobic nature, organozinc compound in general are prepared using air free techniques. They are unstable towards protic solvent. For many purposes, they are prepared in situ, not isolated, but many have been isolated as pure substances and thoroughly characterized. For the preparation of organozinc compounds, zinc reacts with alkyl halide in diethyl ether to form alkyl zinc halide. Zinc is less electropositive than lithium and magnesium, hence carbon zinc bond is less polar in nature. Here alkyl halide reacting with zinc in diethyl ether to produce alkyl zinc halide. Another method for the preparation of organozinc compound includes the reaction of diiodomethane with zinc copper couple in ether solution. Iodomethyl zinc iodide, a reagent for the preparation of cyclopropane and substituted cyclopropane, is prepared by the reaction of diiodomethane with zinc copper couple in diethyl ether. Zinc copper couple is metallic zinc, surface of which is activated by copper. Here it is diiodomethane reacts with zinc copper couple in ether solution to prepare iodomethyl zinc iodide. We will now discuss Simon-Smith reaction, which utilizes this iodomethyl zinc iodide. Iodomethyl zinc iodide reacts with 2-methyl-1-butene to form 1-ethyl-1-methyl-cyclopropane. The reaction is called Simon-Smith reaction, after the name of Howard Simon and Ronald Smith, who first described the use of organozinc compounds in the synthesis of cyclopropanes. Iodomethyl zinc iodide is also called Simon and Smith reagent. In this example, here you can see this is 2-methyl-1-butene reacting with diiodomethane and zinc copper couple to give the cyclopropane derivative. This Simon-Smith reaction is the most important reaction which involves organozinc compounds. Iodomethyl zinc iodide is usually prepared from zinc activated with copper. The iodomethyl zinc iodide reacts with alkene to form cyclopropanes. The reaction is stereospecific with respect to alkene. The substituents which are trans in alkenes are trans in cyclopropane also. The mechanism of reaction is concerted. that is bond breaking and bond making takes place simultaneously. Now, iodomethyl zinc iodide resembles carbenes and is often referred to as carbenoids. And all of you must be knowing what carbenes are. Carbenes actually are the neutral reaction intermediates in which one of the carbon has 6 valence electrons. Such carbons are divalent and are directly bonded to 2 other atoms and have no multiple bonds. Evidence indicate that carbenes are formed as intermediate during Simon-Smith reaction. The reaction is best viewed as the nucleophilic carbon-carbon double bond causing loss of iodide leaving group and the electron from the nucleophilic carbon zinc bond being used for the formation of other carbon-carbon bond. Cis-2-butene forms cis-1,2-dimethylcyclopropane as a result of bond breaking and bond making together, and that is why the reaction mechanism is a concerted one. Here you can see in this mechanism of the reaction, carbon-carbon double bond of the alkene acts as nucleophile, while the iodomethyl group, this iodomethyl group acts as electrophile. There is a transition state formation where you can see all the bonds are either in making mode or in breaking mode. That is, this carbon-carbon double bond is breaking, these two bonds are in the making mode. Similarly, these two bonds are also breaking. As a result of this transition state, the product formed is a cyclopropane derivative along with zinc iodide. Simon-Smith reaction is stereospecific in nature. Stereospecificity is a property of a reaction that leads to different stereoisomeric reaction products from different stereoisomeric reactants. Substituents that are trans in alkene remain trans in the product. For example, trans-2-butene forms trans-1,2-dimethylcyclopropane via this Simon-Smith reaction. Here you can see this is trans-2-butene and it is forming trans-1,2-dimethylcyclopropane. If we start with cis-2-butene, then the product becomes cis-1,2-dimethylcyclopropane. Another example where we have utilized Z3-hexene, which upon reaction with diiodomethane in presence of zinc copper couple forms cis Z or cis, because they are synonym to each other, cis-1,2-diethylcyclopropane. Here in this example, when we start with E3-hexene, the product becomes the trans product. So, with the help of all these examples, we can say that this Simon-Smith reaction is a stereospecific reaction. Now, we will discuss the similarity between Simon-Smith reaction and epoxidation reaction. Before that, what actually is epoxidation? Epoxidation is the reaction of alkene with per acid to form epoxide, a 3-membered ring compound having an oxygen atom. Here you can see that this is the carbon-carbon double bond and alkene reacting with per acid to form epoxide. Both iodomethyl zinc iodide and per acid behave like a weak electrophile. Mechanism of both the reactions are concerted. Both the cycloaddition reactions are faster with more substituted alkene, but are sensitive to steric hindrance. Iodomethyl zinc iodide, unlike other organometallic compounds, behave like an electrophile. We will now discuss retrosynthetic analysis. An important feature of planning a synthesis is reasoning backward from the target molecule to the suitable starting material. E.J. Corey of Harvard University developed a systematic strategy for planning the synthesis of a target molecule, and for this he got Nobel Prize in the year 1990. This is called retrosynthetic analysis. The symbol used to indicate its retrosynthetic step is an open arrow written from the product to suitable precursor. The target molecule to precursor is represented by this open arrow. We will now discuss this retrosynthetic analysis with the help of an example. Here we have a molecule. This is 1-methyl bicyclo 510-octane. We have to prepare this molecule and we have to plan the synthesis, like we have to find out what are the starting material which will give us this compound in good yield. Now, since we know already that Simon-Smith reaction is able to introduce a CH2 group into the molecule, this part of the molecule or this part of CH2 can be introduced from diiodomethane. And if we cut these bonds between these two carbons and between these two carbons and a double bond is introduced, then we will be able to prepare this desired molecule. And this is what we do in case of this retrosynthetic analysis. See here, in this molecule, cut these two bonds and make a double bond over here, and you have got this precursors which will be utilized for this synthesis of our desired compound. And hence, starting from methyl cycloheptene, 1-methyl bicyclo 510-octane can be prepared by treating it with diiodomethane and zinc copper couple in diethyl ether. Another reaction given by organozinc compound is the nucleophilic addition to carbonyl compound. A organozinc compound react with carbonyl compound to form alcohol. If you remember the reaction of Grignard reagent with carbonyl compound, they also form alcohol. Like Grignard reagent reacts with formaldehyde, forms primary alcohol, reacts with any other aldehyde other than formaldehyde, then it forms secondary alcohol, and with ketones it forms the tertiary alcohol. In the same line, organozinc compounds also react with carbonyl compound and they form primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. But the reaction is slow in case of organozinc compound. What is the reason behind it? I think you all know the polarity of carbon magnesium bond and carbon zinc bond. Which of the two is more polar? Obviously, magnesium has higher electropositive character, so that bond is more polar and that is why that is more reactive. And that is why in case of organozinc compound, the reaction takes place, but it is a slow reaction. Organozinc compounds have very low reactivity towards organic electrophiles like carbonyl compounds. The reaction follows the same route. Organozinc compound react with carbonyl compound and is converted into the corresponding alcohol. We will now discuss some applications of organozinc compounds. These compounds can be used for the preparation of bicyclic compounds. You already know we have utilized them for the preparation of cyclic compounds in case of Simon-Smith reaction. Here we will utilize organozinc compound for the preparation of bicyclic compound. The reaction of cyclohexene with diiodomethane and zinc copper couple in diethyl ether forms bicyclo 410-heptane. Here it is cyclohexene reacting with diiodomethane. So, when we started with an alkene, there was formation of this cyclopropene nucleus only. When we started with a cyclic alkene, there is formation of bicyclo compounds. Organozinc compounds can be used for the preparation of spiro compounds also. Spiro compound are the bicyclic organic compounds with ring connected through just one atom. Like you can see in this example, this is cyclopentane ring and this is cyclopropane ring. And these two rings are joined together only through one carbon. That is why this molecule is called spiro 4-2-heptane. This kind of compound can also be prepared from organozinc compound when methylene cyclopentane is reacted upon with diiodomethane and zinc copper couple in diethyl ether, this compound is formed. Another application of organozinc compound is in Reformatsky reaction. Carbonyl compounds react with alpha haloesters in presence of zinc to form beta hydroxy esters. Acetaldehyde reacts with ethyl bromoacetate in presence of zinc to form ethyl 3-hydroxybutanoate, a beta hydroxy ester, as you can see here. Organomagnesium and organocopper compounds do not undergo Reformatsky reaction. The reason is organomagnesium compounds are highly reactive, and instead of forming the desired product, they form byproducts also. Organocopper compounds are less reactive than organozinc compound, and that is why the first step does not take place. So, organozinc compounds or zinc metal in itself is just appropriate for this reaction to be done, and that is why the organozinc compound are formed during Reformatsky reaction, a very good application of organozinc compound. Another coupling reaction takes place with organozinc compound is called Negishi coupling. The Negishi coupling is a widely used transition metal catalyzed cross coupling reaction. The reaction couples organic halides with organozinc compounds, forming carbon-carbon bond in the process. A palladium species is generally utilized as the metal catalyst. Organozinc compounds are sensitive to moisture and air. So, Negishi coupling must be performed in an oxygen and water free environment. The reaction is named after Aishi Negishi, who was a co-recipient of 2010 Nobel Prize in Chemistry for the discovery and development of this reaction. In this reaction, you can see that alkyl halide reacting with organozinc halide to form an alkane. A carbon-carbon bond has been developed during the reaction. Another application of organozinc compound is in the development of Barbier reaction. This reaction involves nucleophilic addition of a carbanion equivalent to a carbonyl compound. The conversion is similar to that of Grignard reaction. The organozinc reagent is generated via an oxidative addition into the alkyl halide. The reaction produces a primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol via 1,2 addition. Here you can see that this is the carbonyl compound and this is organozinc compound. Depending upon the nature of starting carbonyl compound, the product alcohol is formed. If R1 and R2 are H, then the product will be a primary alcohol. If out of R1 and R2 only one is alkyl group, then the product will be a secondary alcohol. And if R1 and R2 both are alkyl groups, then the product will be a tertiary alcohol. Another application of organozinc compound is in Franklin-Dupin reaction. In this reaction, which was developed in the year 1863, an oxalate ester reacts with an alkyl halide, zinc and hydrochloric acid to form alpha hydroxy carboxylic ester. As has been shown here, this is the oxalic ester reacting with alkyl halide and zinc and hydrochloric acid to form alpha hydroxy carboxylic ester as the product. To sum up the present lecture, we have discussed the importance of organozinc compounds and their nomenclature. Then we have discussed the nature of carbon metal bond and their polarity. We have then discussed organozinc compounds, their preparation, then the most important reaction undergone by organozinc compound, that is Simon-Smith reaction, the mechanism of this reaction, the stereospecificity of this reaction, and then the retrosynthetic analysis. We have then discussed the similarity between Simon-Smith reaction and epoxidation, and finally, the nucleophilic addition reaction to carbonyl compounds. After that, we have discussed some applications of organozinc compound in organic synthesis, which includes Reformatsky reaction, Negishi coupling, Barbier reaction, and Franklin-Dupin reaction. In the next episode of organometallic compound, we will discuss organolithium compound. We will discuss their methods of preparation and various reactions undergone by the organolithium compounds. Thank you very much.